This video, I want to talk about some OpenRoads Designer seed files. Seed files we'll be talking about specifically would be, if I right click on one of my folders here, I go to copy seed, there's going to be two files, the ORD 2D seed and the ORD 3D seed. Those are the ones we'll be talking about. You just want to give that a name and make sure that you assign your coordinate system here. And another thing to remember is OpenRoads Designer will create and manage these 3D models. So with that said, almost all your files are going to be using the 2D seed. Your geometry, your corridor files, super elevation, earthwork, plan drafting, your sheet files, plan, profile, cross-section, drainage files, text files. If you had a shading file, those would all be 2D. The only files that you're going to use for 3D are going to be with terrains and survey. When you're creating corridors, those also, remember, are going to be a 2D seed. You'll be breaking these corridors up into ramps, bridges, before and after is when you'd break these corridors, side roads, entrances could be in their own corridors. If you have really long projects, it's going to be typically 2 miles per corridor. Something to remember is when you're creating files is place linked objects in their own file. For example, do not create a terrain from a corridor in the corridor file. This terrain should just be in its own file. And this will be making opening the file easier, making changes. And it's not that you can't do that, but it's best practice to segregate your data and keep that terrain in its own file. For every time that you'd make a change to the corridor, it's going to be trying to update that terrain. I think it makes it easier for other users to come in and see and find the terrains or find your corridors and not have all that information in one place. Another example, don't create super elevation in the corridor file. Create super elevation in its own file. Civil cells, same thing. Place these in their own file. Super elevation, cross sections, earthwork, all this stuff should be in its own file. Again, OpenRoads Designer is designed to work with the reference files, so segregate your data to create a more efficient workflow. Some things we can talk about here are geometry. Are multiple members working on the geometry? Segregating geometry will allow multiple people to work on the geometry for the project. You could create a container file and reference all the geometry to this file. And then you can reference this master file when you want all the geometry. This is really good for people that are outside the office. They could just reference the one file and get all the geometry. Same thing, you can do that same thing for corridors. Create individual corridors based on the geometry. This also allows multiple people to be working on corridors, and you could reference corridors together to see the whole project. You could create a container file. Again, this is just a blank file, and you reference in all the corridors. And then you could reference that container file to see all of the corridors. Something to be concerned here to take note of is the live nesting. When live nesting is set to anything greater than 0, it causes the reference file's children to be attached as well as possibly their children. What's the advantage? This does allow non-CAD users to get all the info instead of searching through all the files. Able to create container files by referencing only one file to get all the information. We'll go ahead and show you that here in a minute. ORD MicroStation does recognize duplicate references and manage those. What's the disadvantage? It can be a burden to manage all the extra references. Can cause file bloating or just too much information that is not needed. There's really not going to be a best practice, but the best way is to set your nesting to 0, and this gives you more control on what is referenced. So to go over some of this here, this referencing, is I just have a 2D seed file here, and I want to start creating a corridor for my side road. What files would I want to reference? I have a few choices. I could reference a container file that has all my geometry, because I'm going to need my geometry to create the corridor. So we can go ahead and do that quick here. So here's my container file. I'll go ahead and attach that. I'll have the nesting set to 0. And if I do a fit view, you can see there down here in the bottom, no elements are found. Well, this is the container file. And remember, my live nesting I set to none or no nesting, but if I turn on live nesting and have this step set to one, now I'm going to get all my geometry for this project. In this example, you know, there's not very many. So I could start here. So at this case, then I could go ahead and reference my terrain and make that active and start creating my corridor. What would be my other option? I could, let's go ahead and detach this file. I could just reference the individual geometry that I need for the corridor. Instead of referencing the container file and getting a lot of geometry I may not need at all. So I could just reference my individual piece of geometry with nesting set to zero. And you'll see here I get my side road geometry. And then here I could go ahead and now I would attach my terrain. So here's my terrain. I would make this active. Once I make that terrain active, it's going to create the 3D model for me, and this is all managed by ORD. But there's a few things that I'm missing here. I know I'm going to need my through roadway geometry, and I'm going to need to see that corridor. I could do a few things here. I could reference the individual geometry for the through roadway or the mainline geometry. I could reference that container file again. I also know I need that corridor file, so let's go ahead and try that. So if I want to attach the through roadways corridor, I'll go ahead and attach that, and I'll have my nesting set to zero. And you can see it brings in my corridor. But I also remember I want that geometry. So what I could do is, for that corridor, I could set my nesting to 1. And remember, this is going to bring in everything that would be attached in a depth of 1, or nesting depth of 1 for corridor MLA. So if I had my super elevation reference to that file or my plan drafting, all that stuff would come over as well. So here you can see that I've got some stuff here. So in my level display, this is kind of how I look at my references. You can see in my corridor MLA with my live nesting set to 1, it attached the through roadway, that GOML geometry. I don't want to see the 3D here, so I can just go ahead and turn that off. If I didn't want to see any of the through roadways 2D stuff, I could go ahead and turn that off. And here's the geometry for my through roadway. And that's one way to do it. And notice too, in this level hierarchy here with the nesting depth of 1, it did not bring over the terrain for corridor MLA. It recognizes that that terrain already exists in this file. So all of those are options. The best practice is probably to have everybody on your team have set up the file so they're all the same. Whether you reference the container file to all your corridors to get your geometry, or you reference the individual ones, or set a nesting depth for the corridors to bring all that information. It's really just having everybody on the same page. Another file that we can look at is what happens when I'm going to reference survey. So I have an example here. Got a geometry file, a 2D seed file that I created. It's got some geometry in it. I'll go ahead and open that. So here I have some geometry and I want to reference some survey. So the survey file I'm looking for is this one here, this sur under bar PO with the county route and parent number here. Go ahead and open that. I'll put no nesting. I'll fit view and you can see I didn't get anything when I referenced this survey file. So this would be a good one where I'm going to need to set the live nesting to 1 when I reference these files. Survey is creating a container file and any additional survey they're using these here. I'll have to wait for the program to respond. You can see now I have all of my survey information with that nesting depth set to 1 with my additional surveys that I need. Those are just a few things to remember when you're creating and working with your seed files and setting up some of the files.